Hey everybody, Vacationer Tom here with John Self, food blogger, theme park blogger, and good, or just all-around good person. We're here at Universal Studios, Florida for their Christmas. Is it Grinchmas? Is the official, the whole thing?
Holidays. Grinchmas is only
holidays. They have a parade float out with Shrek and some characters there. We're actually in line to get a photo with Earl the Squirrel. But join us while we go around Universal Studios Florida and check out their holiday offerings. All right, we just had a great interaction with Earl Squirrel.
I don't know that Tom had a great interaction. He didn't get into Earl the Squirrel.
I did. John was doing a whole skit.
There's a whole stick with Earl. Yeah. You got to work with me here.
So, the crepe stand has a turkey sandwich one. Turkey dinner, $11.99. Roasted turkey breast, cornbread stuffing, gravy, cranberries, and cornbread croutons.
Before applicable discount.
Oh, yes. Discounts. Oh, my.
But
oh,
you
my.
Need me because I can get you a larger discount.
Have you gotten this?
I got it in previous years. It is the same.
Okay. Superb.
It's pretty good.
Better than the brisket that we had during that one video. I'll put the video link up here.
I would get the brisket.
Wow, really? Still brisket. Okay. Well, now, I was going to get this, but John says to go over to. What is this?
This is Battery Park area.
Battery Park.
Horror Nights. This is where the.
It's a drink station, as far as I know.
After Hour Bar was. They use this every holiday season and Mardi Gras.
So he said there's better food over here. So.
I said there were far more options.
Oh, more options. Okay, huh? I want quality of food, John. But you know, we'll go over here, take a look, and we will see. Oh, there's Rip Ride going up the hill. They should decorate that as a Christmas tree or something, yeah? Put lights
up.
Yeah,
they have such good luck with that banner. That's a great plan.
Yeah. Man, it didn't take that long to get it back. Oh, they have this nice and decorated too. All right, let's go over here. Well, I mean, I guess we're already here.
Yep.
All right. Ooh, what is that thing? Oh, that's the turkey dinner. That does look delightful. Shiner Holiday Cheer. Peanut butter fluff and stuff. Peanut butter jelly marshmallow cream. Oh. Then the turkey dinner. Oh man. So good. Oh, naughty nog. This place is awesome. Alright, I'm getting a nog.
She doubted me.
I'm getting a which nog? Ooh, not the fireball. Maybe a deluxe nog. Or classic nog. Classic nog and a turkey dinner. All right, here we go. It's the classic nog with the turkey dinner sandwich. And John got the vegan BLT. It looks delicious. Oh, wow. That looks like lizard skin. That bacon. Bacon.
They fed it to us at the media event, if that tells you anything.
Wow, okay. Very good. I love spiked nog, so I can never get enough of that. Let me take a bite of this and see how it is. All right, I ate half of it. Very good. What was it? 10, 11 bucks? 12 bucks?
I believe that is $10.99 before applicable discount.
Not bad. I mean, if I was going to have a turkey dinner sandwich, though, I would go to Earl's Sandwich.
You'd go to Earl's Sandwich? Yeah, yeah. I think that's fair.
Yeah, yeah. But this is theme park, so.
Right. I think that's fair. This is the argument of that maybe we should have, afterwards you should have the turkey sandwich at Breadbox. The holiday sandwich at Breadbox.
Oh.
Then you compare apple with apples. Spoiler, Earl's is better. But you don't get gravy at Earl's. You get gravy with your sandwich.
Interesting. Yeah, I do like the gravy. I'm dipping it in.
Yeah.
It's a nice touch. But I think Earl's has enough. Earl and Earl, there's a lot of continuity going on.
It's confusing,
on.
Yes.
Yeah, a lot more. Does this have cranberry? I don't know.
For those of you missing, there is an Earl of Sandwich service over at Disney Springs.
Yes.
And I changed subjects because we're the bread box in City Walk Universal.
They're comparable.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, very good though. I highly recommend the eggnog for sure. All right, we just finished eating. It's now 4:50. The parade is at 5:30, and John has advised that we go get in line. So that's in fact what we're going to go do. because we want to bring the parade to you. I've never seen this parade, so I'm actually quite excited to check it out. And I know at the end, Santa lights the Christmas tree.
You haven't seen this parade?
I have never.
Okay.
Wow, look at that. Transformers, 10-minute wait.
It's been about 10, 15, 20 minutes all day.
That's what it deserves.
I'm not a fan of Transformers?
Not throwing shade on Transformers, but if you're going to ride one of these rides, go over next door and ride Spider-Man. Ooh, look at the pretty decorations.
Wow, did you all listen to how quickly his voice changed there? Okay. All I'm saying.
Oh,
it's make your conclusions.
Glorious. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Oh, here's the big tree.
That's right.
It's a glorious tree. So he comes in from where?
He comes around that way.
Well, I mean, the tree's already lit, so what's going on here?
Oh, my friend.
It's not really lit.
Oh, my friend.
It's fake lit. Okay, I got you. All right, here we are. This is supposed to be a really good spot. See behind that white line.
Yeah, the best part's going to be you get to watch the balloons and the floats come through and watch how hard it's going to be with that obnoxious blue construction wall.
Wall of blue. They make this hard right turn. Go down that way.
And they're going to pause along the way so you can watch people dance because the music's going to keep going.
Oh, thank goodness. All right. I tell you who's the luckiest man in the world right now?
Who?
Jimmy Fallon. Look at that view he gets every night of this parade. He just stands there loving life. All right, as we wait for the parade, John, I noticed there are some holiday cups, refillable cups.
Yep.
So what's the story with those?
Those, every season they have the freestyle cups they come out with. They had them for Halloween Horror Nights. They have them for the holidays.
In fact,
they'll have them for Mardi Gras. This is the one from 2021.
So that's still good.
Yeah, you can always bring your cup back in the freestyle to recharge it.
So is it like most parks, the first day it's free refills?
No, and every after? Well, first day, currently if you purchase one cup, it's $17.99. There's discounts for purchasing more than one at a time. And every time you bring it back, you can recharge it for $10.99.
Okay, so your first purchase comes with a refill.
For the whole day.
24 hours.
Yeah.
And that includes a resort?
No.
Oh, no.
No.
So you leave the park, CityWalk?
The CityWalk. There's CityWalk, there's one freestyle station in CityWalk.
Yes, but it does include
it does not include that. It does not include the theme park resorts.
Wow, okay, all right, good to know. So they can bring back these Christmas cups next year and they can just refill or recharge.
I still have a Universal Orlando annual pass cup from 2012 that I bring back
still
periodically.
Still recharges?
Yeah.
Wow.
As long as your RFID chip works.
Still works. Oh, there you have it, folks. Bring in your old cups. We'll be right back. the parade. I was surprised that the Grinch did not appear in the parade.
Grinch does not leave Grinchmas.
Oh, so he's over there full time.
Yep.
He's on lockdown.
He occasionally pops into the annual pass holder lounge. That's it.
Ah, very nice. All right, well, that was the parade. Fantastic. I really enjoyed that parade. Very good. Dare I say my favorite over Mardi Gras?
Oh, well, you're going to say that with me here?
I know. Those are fighting words.
Right, for those of you wondering, I feel Mardi Gras is the best parade in all of Orlando area.
Yeah, it's crazy. But now we're going to head over to IOA and try to hit the... So what's it called officially? The castle show.
Oh, the Holiday Lights at Hogwarts Castle? Something lame like that.
Well, that's a weird ending of that title, but yeah. We'll go with it. All right, we're going to go there now and see if we can hit that. All right, we made it into IOA. Arguably one of my favorite parks to walk into. And at Christmas time, it does not disappoint. How lovely. Of course, some of these lights up were up in August, or not August, but in October.
Yes. Middle of October, right on schedule.
Yep. I am coming back to this park on another day to hit the Dr. Seuss stuff. So I will just put that in, right? Well, I guess when we get up here, I'll just throw it in the middle. And no one will realize that it's now daytime and you're not with me.
Famous words of vloggers that it doesn't get edited improperly. Okay.
Yeah. The Incredible Hulk coaster. It's very nice. They should turn those headlights to red for Christmas. Wow. You got the green with the red.
That's going to go well on the Hulk look. Yeah. And now we're going to make a turn and now we'll see why.
Ooh. I told you I'm going to be right in the video. Look how pretty. So John, what offerings? They obviously, you can meet the Grinch, which is a very hard ticket to get, right?
You have to win your virtual queue.
So you gotta come first thing in the morning, get in the virtual queue.
That would be your best shot, because unlike Walt Disney World, they do not tell you when they're gonna drop them.
Yeah.
8:45, 11, 1, and 3. Not that I know.
Ah, okay. Hypothetically speaking.
Yes. But they don't tell you that.
Yeah.
And it can change based on traffic and problems and lines, because they drop them when they see the line is too short of line.
I gotcha.
They manually manipulate it.
So they have that. They actually have a show. Where's the show?
Christmas show. We'll get around this corner before we get to Circus McGurkus Cafe Stupendous, and you'll see a big sign that says Grinchmas.
And those
day spectacular.
And those are more. That's more of a daylight show.
Well, it's inside the former Blue Man Group. So.
Oh, wait, is this line for the show?
Yeah, that's the line to get to the show, and I don't know those people are going to make it.
Wow. So they still have shows into the night, because right now it's 6:16. So
according to the Grinch of Media event, there are 8 shows a day.
8? Okay. What
do you? He's right. He is right.
Do you know what the lay? Oh, lay is a 7. Okay.
That's why they recommend you arrive 30 minutes before.
Earliest is what time was it? 11 something?
First one was 11:15.
11:15. So when I come back, when you see this, it'll probably be 11:15 show.
All right, 10:30, and they open up the rope. So we're moving to probably waiting area number 2. Or I doubt we're going to sit down at this point, 45 minutes before the first show. But at least we're moving closer, and we'll be in the shade. Actually, it was really cold this morning, but it's warming up nicely now. All right, we went backstage, and now we're in line before we get into the area. I didn't realize it was so far back here. That's cool. All right, got seated. 11:03. Show's gonna start in 15 minutes. Well, 12 to be precise.
And now, Universal Orlando asks that you open your heart and enjoy the Grinchmas Hula Day Spectacular.
Yes, every who down in Whoville likes Christmas a lot. But the Grinch, who lives just north of Whoville, does not.
Noise, 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 noise. Christmas music. It's joyful and triumphant.
The Grinch hates Christmas. The whole Christmas season. Now, 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 please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be because his head isn't screwed on quite right. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes are too tight. But I believe the most likely reason of all is that his heart is too silent, too small.
please make sure you have all of your items and take small children by the hand as you exit. Universal Orlando extends the warmest of seasonal wishes from our family.
They got, the meat, they got the show, special food.
Special food, some which is over at Hop and Pop, your favorite place to make fun of. The roast beef sandwich at Circus McGurk's Cafe Stupendous, which is the only reason to go in there.
Nice, all right.
We are here at night versus the day, so the Hoos are not out doing their stick, interacting with people.
Okay, yeah, the Hoos are a daytime thing. They come out and they...
Approximately 11:15 to 5:30 every day.
All right. So maybe I'll get some footage of that as well.
Approximately.
Oh yeah, approximately. Very beautiful.
I think that's all that's involved in Seuss Landing.
Now, is there any chance that Death Eaters come out and do Christmas carols?
Absolutely not.
Oh, that's a bummer.
Death Eaters, we're lucky we get them during October.
This one, is there? Like the Halloween one, at least there was some type of a little bit of a story, I think.
There's less story, there's more celebration of the Christmas elements of the movie.
Yes.
That's why you get the Yule Ball, you get the Weasleys.
Ah, alright. Fair enough. It's a fine show. Alright, well, I think that might wrap it up for this. The only other thing we didn't do, which we guess we can insert right now, is a tribute store. Oh. That's cool. $36 even. That's weird. That's an odd price. Ice skaters aren't moving, but... Fake candle. Oh, nice cup. $15 even. Again, going with the even numbers instead of the 99 cents. $19 even. Ooh, I like this. I used to have these lights on my tree as a child when they heat up the water bubbles. $19. That's cool. A wooden Santa advent calendar. That's cool. Has drawers. Kind of like the one over there. 116. Oof. Well, this guy is very talkative this morning. This dude has not much to say. Okay. Interesting. They come with gumdrops. Now you have till 4:30 to eat them. Let's see. $26 eating.
Very hard to get in and out. Chocolate frogs. That's not holiday, but okay. $14. Thank you for that. Wands. Oh, okay. This is all Harry Potter. Wow, look at these things. Oh, they are not fluffy in the least. Ah, this is all Harry Potter. I mean, I'm nothing against it. The chess set, that's cool though. I mean, I think I'd still rather have the Haunted Mansion one that I saw at Disney Springs. Yeah, again, I don't know. They're adverse to having prices on these, which I don't know. A little odd, I guess. All right, let's get out of Harry Potter. Ah, cool. Wonder how recent these are. Very nice. Whoville. All right, this is more like it. Ah. Grinch onesie. It's actually pretty comfortable. Oh, here we go, $59.95. Back to the odd numbers. It's actually not a bad price considering we got that one at SeaWorld and I think it was more than that. Let's see how much one of these shirts are. 27. Drama set would be really cool. Let's see. So 35 for the bottom, 35 for the top. So $70 total. Again, with AP discount, wouldn't be that bad. Grinchman's lanyard, 13. I like that. Maybe. If it is discounted then the seating, I'll get one. Earl the Squirrel. Let's see what some Earl merch is like. 37. Oof. Earl don't come cheap. What an Earl pillow. There we go. 45. That seems a little outrageous. Of course, I don't price pillows every day, but it seems a little high. This doesn't look like a... Oh no, this is a real ceramic mug. Mary Ann Nutty, Earl the Squirrel. 15, so that's not bad. I'd consider that. This is nice. Gonna be expensive, I'm sure. Oh, 29. Could be worse. Greetings from Mistletoe Pines Village, Universal Studios. I'm guessing this is gonna be 33, so a little less. Oh, you have your own little Earl, though. I don't know. Doesn't look very Earl-like to me. Hello. Grinch caramel apples for $12. Hot cocoa cake. Ooh, eggnog mousse. What's your best seller?
Probably the jar cakes are pretty popular.
Yeah,
but
I can see
the
that.
Best seller is going to be the gingerbread cookie sandwich all the way at the bottom in the middle.
Oh, that does look good. Gingerbread cookie sandwich. What's in the middle of it?
It's like a whipped marshmallow frosting. So it's like eating an oatmeal cream pie, but it doesn't taste like one. It's gingerbread. It's like that same consistency.
Hmm. All right. I think you talked me into it. I will have one, please.
And right now, just due to like inventory, they're buy one, get one free. The sandwiches. So
really? Oh, my.
Fantastic, thank you. All right, 2 for 1. It was $8.63 after an AP discount. They're $9 regularly, but still, buy one, get one free. She says they sell out. They've got a new batch in, so I'm not gonna argue about that. All right, the gingerbread cookie. Let's go for it. The gingerbread's nice and soft. Yeah, the cream is marshmallowy. Very good. $9 for one cookie. Well, I guess technically it's two cookies. It's a sandwich, but when you buy one, get one free, it's much better value. All right. I would recommend, if you like gingerbread and you like sweets, maybe if you have a cup of coffee with you, that'd be helpful.
Definitely a good event to come out to. No, and once again, I write this constantly. I cannot emphasize this enough. This is a holiday experience, even though it's only focusing on one holiday. I can say that as a Christian minister, that it's only focusing on one.
Yeah.
All the things involved, with the exception of the Grinch breakfast and the special after hours holiday tour, is included with your regular admission. This
yes,
is not, you
that
gotta
is key.
Pay for very Merry Christmas,
that,
$50.
Yes.
Okay.
It's a very good event, like John said. It's free with admission to the park. Of course, you need to have that. But yeah, parade, the tribute store, the show. Oh, the Christmas show. So good. And you see
special food.
Earl the Squirrel.
Oh, I forgot about Earl.
The Grinch. I mean, come on. What more could you want?
You do have special shows, which not a big deal. The Blues Brothers have a special show, and Marilyn has a special show. And Celestina has a special show.
I will say, I do want to see the Blues Brothers holiday show. That would be fantastic.
Because you're a snowman?
Because I am a snowman, baby. Also, Mannheim Steamroller came, and they played, what, like four shows?
They had four concerts.
Four shows that were also free with admission.
With your price of admission.
So, you know, if you like some Christmas music, that's nice too. So yeah, very good event. I thank everyone for joining me. John, do you want to give any plugs?
I guess at this very moment as we're recording this, I can plug that you can see all of this holiday information in written form on piratesandprincesses.net. Simply search my name for them or Universal Holidays, and it should link you to pretty much all of that stuff.
Nice, nice. And of course,
including a tour of the Green and Red Coconut Club.
Oh, wow.
With the assistance of Alicia Stella and Main Street Magic.
Wow, big leaguing me here on my own vlog. Can you believe this? Can you believe this guy?
We went to see Earl the Squirrel.
Oh, that okay,
you
but
can't
still.
See Earl the Squirrel without a reference to Alicia.
All right. Yeah, so, and of course you have a Twitter, Pastor John Self.
Yes.
J-O-N.
J-O-N,
no,
because H's are ooh.
H's are ooh. Or are they who for the Whoville? But I think that will be a good place to end this one. So please go to the podcast, or go to the podcast. Well, you can go to the podcast, Occasionally State Parks and More, wherever you stream podcasts. But go to the YouTube channel, like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. To all my subscribers, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And to all my future ones, the exact same thing, actually. Same message. Happy Holidays, Merry Christmas, and thank you, thank you, thank you. But until next time, Happy Holidays, and keep making memories. I'm not sure I did spooky memories. You can tell we're getting close to Harry Potter land because it's starting to congest a little, yeah?
And for those of you scoring at home, yes, he called it Harry Potter land to see if my head would explode.
That's right.
Acceptable answers are Wizarding World or Hogsmeade.
Harry Potter land is perfectly acceptable too for the layman. Yeah,
that's kind of like people who call this place Universal Studios Orlando. There is no such place. Never been
such
to a place.
A stickler.
Never exists one.
Thanks for watching the Vacationers Podcast YouTube channel. Please subscribe if you enjoy our content and ring the bell to receive notifications when new videos are released. Please like our Facebook page, Vacationers Theme Parks and More. And follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Vacationers Podcast. If you'd like to enjoy more of our content, listen to our podcast, Vacationers Theme Parks and More. It can be found on most streaming platforms. And lastly, I would like to thank everyone who has either subscribed or follow us on social media. Your support is greatly appreciated. Thank you, and keep making memories.